knew Chloe would be all over this. So I better get moving. I still can't stop thinking about Kate. It's like I'm awake in a bad dream. You know you're hurting when you don't give a shit about music. See, Lisa? At least I kept you alive. Guess I'm better with plants than people. Hey, Bunny, don't be too bummed, but from now on, I'm your new mommy. Are you hungry, Bunny? Here, nosh on this. Come on, Max. No more tears. You have to act, not react. Pretty hard to focus on my class schedule this week. I wonder why. No way can I clean that shit off. Time to get Samuel da Vinci to repaint. Jeepus, I am so freaking tired. I sound like a moron. But crime does not delay. I need to stay on top of this investigation. Okay, this is scary dark. Let there be... Kate, I would give up my power if I could have another rewind to save you. I won't rest until we find out the truth, and somebody pays for this. This is my prayer for you, Kate. Bless your gentle soul. God, that's like some awful TV crime scene in our dorm. So much hypocrite.
Hey, Max. I saw you go up on the roof to try to help Kate. I can't believe she jumped.
I can. I just wish I could have stopped her. Are you okay?
I'm just, like, numb. I've never seen anybody actually die.
Me neither. I didn't think you'd be so upset considering how much shit you and Victoria gave Kate.
I'm my own person, not Victoria's bitch. Hello, like, she's freaking too. She already broke curfew tonight. Shit, I'm not supposed to tell anybody.
Where did she go?
I know I can trust you since you were so nice asking about my mom in the hospital, but Victoria will, like, make my life hell if I blab, okay?
No doubt. I do hope your mother gets better. Let me know if you need anything.
Thanks. You're, like, weird, but pretty cool, Max. Especially after watching you go up on that roof. Victoria's wrong about you. Now I have to be alone for my nightly anxiety attack. Talk to you later.
I hope Victoria feels particularly shitty about posting that link. Oh, Victoria isn't here. Maybe I'll just wait and bide my time. Going through her shit. That's a depressing thought. And it's always about Victoria. Victoria is about as street as me. But she really appreciates style. Whoa, I had no idea Victoria's parents owned the Chase space. Color me impressed. A unique point of view is right. Thanks to Courtney Wagner ghostwriting this paper. First Rachel and now Kate? This is the end of the Vortex Club. There has to be some dirt in here on Victoria. Well, well. Maybe Victoria isn't a monster after all. This is like a thread for sociopaths. Max Crackfield? Lame. Party on, dudes. That's a lot of bank just to clean paint from a sweater. Victoria's secret. She's a geek. Here they are getting loaded with Satan. I'll title this one, Portrait de la Assholes. Whoa, there's Kate. Totally high. She looks confused, not like she's partying. These socks cost more than my wardrobe. Those boots are made for walking runways. Nothing to see here. I guess I shouldn't be so bummed. Not that Victoria couldn't hide her shit. Man, I'm getting paranoid. I hope Kate finally has her wings now. Dana looks so sad, even though she's trying not to show it. Hey, Dana. How are you doing?
I just can't stop thinking about Kate. And if this is my fault, too.
I knew she was depressed, but I had no idea how bad.
Must be serious to throw yourself off the roof.
Kate was serious. But it's not all about that video.
So what exactly are you saying, Max? You think this has something to do with Nathan being expelled?
It's complicated. I don't want to drag you into this, okay? Not yet, anyway.
I'm getting scared now. But people here are still sneaking out tonight.
What? Like, who?
Victoria bounced out of here earlier, and now you, Sherlock?
Not me. I need a break from today. Get some sleep too, Dana. I'll see you later. Dana clearly doesn't mind if I peruse her laptop. Aw, Trevor is a sweetie. Good for Dana. If Dana talks to Juliet about this, she's gonna wish she didn't. Yes, the Vortex Club does indeed suck. This is both sad and pathetic. That is so damn cute how much Dana is into this Halloween party. So Chloe is waiting for me in front of the main hall. What the hell am I doing out here? Kate is dead and I'm sneaking around. This campus looks like a cemetery. Maybe Samuel should fix that lamp. The Tabanka does look pretty scary at night. Please don't destroy me. the lens and say nut. Gotcha. Oh, it's unlocked. I hope Sammy wasn't around. Nothing but tools. Nothing here. I know Samuel doesn't wear silky scarves. So, who does? Who knew Samuel was so into runway fashion? Nuts and bolts. Like my grandpa's garage. Jesus. I still can't believe she jumped. Everywhere I go, I can see how I'm altering history. Big and small. Oh, the most magical insects. Burn bright. Principal Wells. Oh, are you serious? I'm toast if he sees me.
Nobody can expel Miss Caulfield. You have to be stealthier than that. You're not supposed to be outside your dormitory at this hour. You know that.
I'm sorry, Principal Wells. I'm still upset about Kate. I needed some air and space to walk.
I'm sorry you had to go through that today. You tried to help, but God damn it, Blackwell is my responsibility. And I let her and Kate down. Go on back inside. Get some rest. It's been a shitty day. Good night, Max.
Great. So how do I get past him to meet Chloe? He's lucky nobody else saw him like that. Except me.
I miss Caulfield.
Max the Ninja strikes again.
Get it? Booyah. Like I'm a scary punk ghost.
More like a scary and sensitive asshole. Chloe, I watched my friend jump off a roof today. I don't think you need to prank me tonight. You always trip out on me for not being there for you, but is this how you're there for me?
I'm sorry, Max. I wasn't even thinking. I suck.
I'm not trying to be a bitch, but I'll never get the image out of my head of Kate jumping off that roof. All because my power didn't work. It didn't mean shit.
I know seeing Kate fall was horrible. I don't even know how to deal with that, so I just act like an idiot. But it's your badass power that's gonna bring all this to a close. We just need to connect the players.
And find out who really killed Kate. We have to stop this from happening to anybody else.
Oh yeah, and somehow stop that tornado from wiping out Arcadia Bay, right?
I hope so, Chloe. But how? Snow and eclipse are bad omens.
This whole town is a bad omen. I noticed that Blackwell seems to be ground zero.
Chloe, I just feel weird about some of my decisions. Especially after I just got Nathan expelled.
Dude, do not even torture yourself like that. Let's focus on looking for clues, okay?
Right. For one thing, there's too much coincidence between the people around Kate and Rachel.
Like Step Prick and Nathan Prescott?
Not just them.
Yep. I just want to beat the shit out of those particular bros.
And even though I don't know her, it feels like Rachel is guiding us to the truth.
Fuck the truth. I just want to find my friend right now. It scares me to think where she could be. Do you think she's...
dead? I'm sorry. I hate even saying that, Chloe.
Not as much as I hate thinking it. Max, we have to find Rachel soon. We have to.
I promise you we will. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues. Now tell me, what's your secret?
Drumroll, please. I present the spare keys to Blackwell. Thank you, Step Prick.
You are such a boss, Chloe. I just don't want you to get into any more trouble.
Look at all the trouble dropping in Arcadia Bay. At this point, who gives a fuck anymore? We're in it to win it, Max. Lead the way.
I'm so glad you're my partner in crime.
As long as you're my partner in time.
Insert groan here.
Thank you again so much for helping me put together a portfolio.
Hopefully the rest of the class will follow your lead. I'm sorry I was distracted, as you know. It's not been a good day for Blackwell.
I know this has been an awful day, and you can talk to me anytime, Mr. Jefferson.
Thank you, Victoria. I imagine you're pretty upset over Kate as well.
I'm, like, still in shock. I've never seen anybody die. I really cared about Katie.
Katie? I had no idea you two were that close. Did she?
Well, how does this affect the Everyday Heroes contest?
It doesn't. The contest is still a go, and I still have to pick the winner to best represent Blackwell. I've got all the photos, except one from Max.
I'll give you a one-word sneak preview of Max's photo. Selfie. Listen, you've seen my entry. You know it's better than that. Wouldn't that be so cool to hang out together in San Francisco, Mark?
Stick to Mr. Jefferson, Victoria, please. And, I haven't picked a winner yet.
You already love my work, so it's not like you're playing favorites. Just imagine if you picked my photo, though. We would have to spend a lot of time together. That could be fun, don't you think?
I'm going to think that you didn't say any of that.
You might as well choose me. Otherwise, I might have to tell people you offered to choose my photo for favors or something.
As a favor to your future, I'll also ignore that undisguised threat. This conversation is officially over, Miss Chase. I suggest you go back to your dorm now.
Wait! I only... Are you fucking kidding me? It's so stupid.
Just when I think Victoria can't get any more evil.
Shit is about to get real at Blackwell.
Let's go find out. Chloe the Keymaster.
You know it.
Dude, I don't know about this. We're both already in so much trouble.
Not to mention the weed you brought into my room. Joking.
I'm serious. We're not kids anymore. We're breaking and entering.
If I have a key, how can it be breaking? They can't charge us for just entering.
I'm serious. We could go to jail.
Not if I'm related to the head of Blackwell Security. Step shit will not want me in the hands of the local police. So we better find out what's in the principal's office first. You can rewind if we get caught, right? You have mad powers, Max.
Tell that to Kate.
Come on. One more door and our work here is done.
That's it. What the fuck? The security officer should have the key to the principal's office.
He's hiding shit, like everybody here.
Well, now we definitely have to get this door open. Believe it or not, I know a little about lockpicking, thanks to Frank. I might as well test out my thief skill.
Go for it. We're already in this deep.
Well, you could look for the key, just in case.
Why, yes, I could. Nothing here. Dead end. Boring. Crap. Only a total phony would wear a crappy hat like that. Here are the keys. None for the principal's office.
No key for thee.
We have to find another way in.
Guess I didn't spend enough time with Frank. But I'll use my DIY lockpick tools while you come up with a better plan.
My plan has a name.
Hey, Warren, you busy?
Just bubble hearth, you'll be okay. Listen, I need your physics expertise stat. Without naming names, if somebody had access to the art and science labs and wanted to construct a device that would, say, open a locked door, would you maybe kinda know how? Huh? No, I'm just asking for fun. Thanks, science guy. No, stay. We need you as backup. Just send the text instructions now. Yes, I'm still all in to go ape with you at the drive-in. Thanks for the hope.
This sucks ass. Goddamn door.
Try not to wake up everybody at Blackwell.
Sorry, Max. I got nothing. What about your plan?
I'm gonna go put it together. Can you stay here and not get caught?
I might get on the other side of that door before you, Lupin.
The race is on. See you soon. Squirrels like nuts. Does that mean Samuel is... Nah. I feel bad for the twee hipster who lost this beret. But Betty's cute. Ooh, sugar. Only 3 more items to go. Warren is such a classic nerd. Let's see if I can find those items. Just emptied. Nothing here. Release the Kraken! It's all mine anyway. You're halfway home, Max. Formalin smell. An A minus? All right. So Dr. Max did help Warren this morning. Ass biology. Ugh, gross. A periodic table. Wish I knew what periodic means. This mixture doth not work.
So sodium chloride is a weed killer. You'd think Warren would have told me that factoid. Everybody's asleep. I hate to wake them up, but I want a picture. Good evening, Fish Fish. Thanks, Fish. Nice work. Please resume your slumber. I never said they were great, troll. You're an artist, damn it, not a scientist. But this is so not sodium chlorate. Here's the sodium chloride box. You know you're clumsy, Max. Don't waste your rewind power. Use the damn chair. Only one more ingredient left. Ew, gross. At least switch to e-cigs. This is like a scene in a horror film. You can never escape the lighthouse here. I feel gross even looking at Nathan's work, but he does have some style. Oh, Kate, even when you were sad, you tried to see the good in the world. Shit. Victoria, that is pretty fucking sweet. How can I hate somebody that shoots like that? Daniel's a better illustrator than photographer, said Max, the art critic. Victoria's cigarettes? I'm sure Mr. Jefferson is impressed. The tape is mine. Now it's time to show Chloe that Max is the bomb. Take it easy on the door, Chloe. Let's try this instead.
Boom! Literally. Yes! Time to blow shit up!
If you'll light the candle.
This is so cool!
Get ready to haul ass.
That was so fucking cool! Oh, we are toast! Here comes the whole Arcadia Bay Fire and Police Department. So what should we do? Shit, shit! Do something, Max.
Thank you.
This ancient door is no match for Max the Magician.
If I can get this bastard open, she can't cheat with her rewind. Oh, this is bullshit. Fuck you, door.
Welcome to my domain.
You are magic! I have no clue how the hell you got in there, but you did it, sister.
The company I keep. Now, let's find what we want and beat it. My powers only go so far.
Man, I can see why the principal locks this room up. Fancy faux art crap. He must want everybody to know he has money. But no taste. How can you trust somebody who has a fucking bronze bird in his office? I'm glad I was expelled.
Yes, if only the principal had a Monet or Picasso, you'd still be at Blackwell.
Eat me. I'm gonna pilfer the papers on this ugly-ass desk. Okay, sure. It's ugly, but damn, is it a cozy chair. This is your chance to truly get all deductive and shit, Sherlock. Find us some clues about Rachel, or Kate, or Nathan. Anybody.
I'm on the case. Chloe, say hello to my little friend. Say goodnight to the bad guy. You're not so tacky up close. That is so cool that my signature actually counted. Go, Miss Grant. This pretty much sums up Kate. Shy and sweet. And in the wrong place. Only two more files to go. I certainly can't use this. Looks like an oil painting spill. Awful. Look at this pile. Wowzer, this will so not come in handy. I'd drink too if I was the principal of Blackwell. And nothing here. Rachel doesn't seem so troubled based on all this. But there's not much here about the police investigation. Man, I don't blame the principal for expelling Chloe. Bad Chloe. Let's nab this last file, Sherlock. Weird. This asshole has a spotless record. Like I'm not gonna read my own personal file. This file is going to be so spotless, I'll projectile vomit. I have to make sure Warren doesn't have a criminal background. So, Nathan Prescott's dad is a bully too. Shocker.
Max, you better come check out these files. Nathan accuses Rachel of bringing drugs on campus, and my step-troll went along because he thinks Rachel was a bad influence on me. Assholes.
If David is teaming up with Nathan Prescott, that's a bad sign.
Nathan Prescott III. Ooh, he's so money. And you know the Prescotts dropped Major Bank to bury Nathan's real file. Look, it reads like a rap sheet. Bad grades, teacher complaints, secret probation. But I was expelled?
At least Nathan was finally suspended. Check out that note. Open it.
It's just some crazy drawing.
It's not a drawing. Look. Rachel in the dark room. Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it.
That's fucked up. What does this even mean? Nathan is truly psychotic. I know he has something to do with Rachel missing.
Whoa, listen to this. David M. always asks what's going on in my head. David M. always helps me follow those he follows. It's pretty cryptic.
No, it sounds like they formed some sort of weird team, the Super Hebros.
Jesus. David was stalking Kate, hassling me, and now we know he was all over Rachel, too.
Oh, we are so going into his garage files. Plus, I'm getting a little paranoid in here. We got our info, let's bail. But maybe we shouldn't leave without a gift.
No, you are not taking the cozy chair.
Max, do your powers include mind reading? Or did you just rewind because I tried to steal the chair? Shit, I'm confused.
It's the powers of best friendship. I know how you roll. We should definitely get out of here. We pressed our luck enough.
Hello, what have we here? Holy shit! Jackpot! Cha-ching!
Wowzer. That's a lot for the handicapped fund.
Dude, there's $5,000 here. I could pay Frank back tonight. This'll chill him out after you almost, you know, shot him. Are you gonna make a big issue out of this? Or just rewind and take the greenbacks for yourself? I hope you do that instead of lecturing me.
Frank knows things about Rachel, and he might talk if he's been paid, right?
You are Supermax. And with the leftover dough, I'll take you on a road trip to Portland for the day. We'll stock up on tats, beer, weed, and donuts.
And books from Powell's.
And strip clubs. Kidding. But you never know.
I feel like shit for taking that money. That impish look scares me.
Care for a midnight swim? The Blackwell pool is ours.
Swimming? You want to take that risk now?
It's been a cray week. We deserve a little mindless fun in the water. We're done for the night anyway. We're rich, and nobody busted us. So? Splish splash?
You're right. We hella deserve it. Splish splash.
Did you actually just say hella? I think I'm a good bad influence on you.
We're in the otter's lair.
Big fucking deal. I want that heated water.
We still have to play it cool, okay? I still go to school here.
You can own this hellhole once you figure out your rewind power.
Chloe is so psyched for girls' night out, so I better follow her evil plan. Go otters. I would love a soda, but I'd just get wired.
Boys or girls?
Boys, of course.
Figures. Perv. Let me check to see if the pool's heated.
I guess somebody forgot their Blackwell spirit. I guess I should consider this evolution.
no way am I touching Zach's jersey. Zach is really careless. Doesn't he know what happens when I'm around? Betty developed that in Jefferson's class. But why? It's okay for Nathan to be hooked on these drugs, right? Some poor hipster lost their vape. Sometimes. Boys' locker room is right. It's nice to know Victoria loves something besides herself. Welcome to 1950. I bet you do. Max Caulfield, moral avenger. Or self-righteous hypocrite. This one is almost empty. The guys must like their pink goo. Bros will be bros. Coffee and swimming. Good combo. Yes, we get it. Otters. Don't even think I'm gonna make a move on you. Hello, gorgeous. You wish, Max. You just look like a snoop. Ooh, pink goo. I see why everybody brings their own soap. This isn't a desperate cry for attention or anything. I hope so, friend. A miracle to save Kate would have been nice. A miracle to save Kate would have been nice. Looks like Brooke wants to go to the drive-in with Warren. Those are some musty-ass old shirts. Yuck. Where does that other sock go? If I could rewind back to the 1940s, I'd get in serious trouble. Those look like the most cozy, comfy towels in towel history. Want? Flippers in a swimming pool? Are they training Navy frogmen here? So, Victoria's secret is selfies. Go fuck your... No. Jefferson said, don't confuse art with the artist. These are cool shots. The wit. It burns. A bus ticket? Was she going to run away? Like Rachel Amber? sorry, Rachel. In case I run out of air, I know where to come. Now I have the power over light and death. Time to do or dive, Max.
Oh yeah, baby. Feels like a hot tub. And with my cash dash, I'm queen of the world. Bow. Tell me you're not gonna stand there watching me like a zombie. Don't you dare! Come stop me, hippie. Okay, you asked for it. Cowabunga! Why, look, an otter in my water. Dun 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 dun. You are so obvious. And I still get freaked out by that movie, so stop. I can't even watch any of those shark shows. I'll just rewind and harpoon you. Otter's revenge.
Cheater.
Yeah, you wouldn't know about that.
I wish Rachel was here. She would totally love being in here at night. Wish you guys had met each other.
We will. With all this stuff going on, I'm starting to think everything is related. And I want to find out why for Kate's sake. She didn't deserve to die.
Your power is changing everything, Max. Especially you. I can already tell. You're not so chicken shit anymore.
Thanks, girlfriend.
You know what I mean. You're becoming like this force of nature.
More like luck of nature. Come on, my power failed trying to rescue Kate. Maybe I'm just stumbling back and forth in time. For what reason?
You didn't stumble when you saved me, Max.
Thank God. But what if I had? What if you and Kate would both be dead?
So it's time to start moving forward in time. And we're obviously connected, since without me, you would have never discovered your power, right?
I don't know.
Well, I do, okay? So just listen to Captain Chloe.
I'm trying. As long as we don't waste this power.
Stop being so goddamn humble. You're like the smartest, most talented person I've ever known.
More than Rachel Amber?
Dude, I'm not her groupie, okay? And I'm sure you have Blackwell bros all over you. Like Warren.
Warren is nice.
Nice? Ouch. That means friend zone.
No, he's really cool. It was so sweet when he stood up to Nathan. But I haven't told him about my rewind power.
No worries. Once you get over yourself, you're gonna make the world bow.
As long as you're there with me.
Don't look so sad. I'm never leaving you.
Now I'm getting cold in here.
Because we're yapping instead of attacking each other, otter versus shark style. I think I've had my pool experience for the year. Let's jet.
Let's call it a draw. I'm gonna freeze my ass off when I get out. Gross. I feel like we just went swimming in Chlorine Bay.
You look cute with your hair soaked in chemicals.
Thanks. You would know.
Hide!
move, Max. Don't waste your power on getting busted. Are you shitting me? Dude, hide! Like when we were kids. I could use my power, or just look for a hiding spot, or both.
Where are they? Hello? Hello? Anybody there? Better not try any Halloween pranks after today. I'm serious. I heard something over here.
We are so invisible.
Let's bail.
Wait, turn around. They're coming. We have to find another way out.
Oh, this is bullshit. You can't go back to your dorm now. You're a Blackwell fugitive. Crash at my place tonight.
You want me to crash where the Blackwell security officer lives so I'll be safe?
Okay. Into the car. Get in. Later, fuckers. Max, you rock. We are so fucking awesome.
Yes, we are.
Always remember this moment.
Photobomb!
Photo hog.
It feels like a different world from yesterday.
We left a skid mark on Blackwell last night.
Like it needs another one. I'd like to do something good for my school in Arcadia Bay. I can't even submit my photo to represent. I just don't want to be rejected.
Every great artist gets rejected before they get accepted. So you have to enter a photo.
Even though I'm pimping the school in town you want to torch?
Come on, I don't want to see Arcadia Bay burn to the shore. I just say shit like that because I've been trying to get out of here since you left, basically. If I could find Rachel, then pay Frank off. I'm still leaving to start a whole new life.
Wish we could just hang out all morning like we used to. Maybe we should get up. I have to get back to Blackwell soon.
Oh, does the schoolgirl have a test today?
I'm starting to feel like going to Blackwell every day is a test. I just need to get on my regular school schedule again.
I know that it is freezing, but I think we have to walk. I keep waving at the taxis, they keep turning.
Okay, I need to get dressed now. I think I'll be moshing today.
Supplies are endless in the evening, by the morning they'll be gone.
Yes, I might go to hell for this, but if it saves Chloe, we'll pay it back. Somehow. Wow. I remember this old phone. We decorated it together. Man, if I had stayed hidden, David wouldn't be targeting me. Nice. Chloe put my pic on her phone. I must have proved I was worthy again. Jesus. Now I am glad Chloe took that money. This guy is serious and scary. Frank might think twice about messing with Chloe now, but... if David finds out, shitstorm. Chloe seems more relaxed now that she has that money from the handicapped fund. Time to put on your daily armor, Max. I'm lucky David didn't bust me for acting like it was my pot. Chloe is so damn cute. She's really trying to suss out what my vision means. At least we haven't been identified. Yet.
Eyes all painted black. Just keep going to the bathroom, or I say you'll be right back. Well, it takes one to know when
I have to go. Especially since Kate's parents aren't going to bury her here.
What's so easy in the evening, by the morning, such a drag. I got a flask inside my pocket, we can share it on the train. And if you promise,
I love this song.
Conscious, I will try and do the same.
Wow, sir, that was my 10th birthday. I didn't know Chloe kept this stuff.
Sure kill all the pain.
The fact that she put the photo next to Rachel's is so touching.
Seems insane. And I'm not sure what the trouble was that started.
Yes, I might go to hell for this, but if it saves Chloe, we'll pay it back. I love this morning light. It's so peaceful.
Wouldn't it be wicked if we could just hang out here forever like when we were kids?
Yes, but sadly we're not kids anymore.
At least you can date now, right? My dad was terrified of the day I would discover boys.
So, you never really told me if you had a serious boyfriend while I was away.
Not serious. Hella stupid, usually. I went through a boy toy phase, among other things.
I can't see you with any of the guys around here.
Because you have a good eye. That's why I was so glad Rachel came along to rescue me.
Sounds like you totally crushed on Rachel.
You would have too. Smart, sexy, and sassy. Like me, right?
Well, duh. Maybe Rachel would have fought over both of us.
You wish. Then again, maybe. You're a photographer, and she wanted to be a model. Hey, lazy ass, put some clothes on. Then we can scarf the awesome breakfast Joyce is cooking up.
Ugh. Still reeks like a chlorine factory.
See if you can find a suitable outfit in my fashion hole.
I don't
don't think I'll be moshing today. Okay, time for some Chloe cosplay.
Hey, there you go. Rachel left a bunch of her clothes with me. She's your size.
But not quite my style.
Max, you don't have a style yet. At least give it a try. You can always rewind back to your chlorine brand t-shirt and generic jeans.
You suck. I like my shirt and jeans. But it would be cool to try on Rachel's clothes just to see if they fit.
Stop second-guessing yourself, Max. Put this on and let your inner punk rock girl come out. You can afford to take chances whenever and whatever you want to try. For example, I dare you to kiss me.
What?
I double dare you. Kiss me now.
Sorry, not that easy.
Oh, like I am? Just admit that you already macked on me, then used your rewind. Now I can text Warren that you're saving yourself all for him.
I am so going to best unfriend you for that. I love that Chloe is so fearless. Okay.
Damn, you're hardcore, Max. Now I can text Warren and tell him he doesn't stand a chance. Unless he's into girl-on-girl action.
You're such a dork. Oh man, that was priceless when I kissed Chloe. She didn't think I would. Okay. Sorry.
Looking sick, Max. A couple tats, some piercings, and we'll make a thrasher out of you yet.
Ready for the mosh pit, Shaka Bra.
Maybe not. Go on down and say hi to Joyce. Free breakfast. I have to, wake and bake first.
I promise not to tell.
Let's not rewind and find out, okay?
Oh my god. That smells so amazing. It's like when we were kids here. Chloe has had this damn dirty pirate towel since we were kids. Serious flashback.
No way. That's the bluebird I saved Monday in Joyce's room.
Chloe never used to care when I borrowed her toothbrush. You know, I haven't gone through a dyeing my hair blue phase yet. Maybe it's time. What's ironic is I always hated it when Chloe used my toothbrush. Feels so good to wash my face after all that chlorine and hiding. Check out Mad Max, ready to fucking thrash. I'm so hardcore. I better not go in there. David might be in bed. Ew. For everybody else in the neighborhood, it's just another morning. For everybody else in the neighborhood, it's just another morning. Joyce looks so different in her street clothes. Good morning, Joyce.
Rachel! Max. Whew, you startled me. Well, you fit those clothes well. Thank God you're not a hellraiser like her or Chloe. Now tell me exactly what you want to chow on.
Eggs and bacon all the way.
Remember when you guys would sleep in until I yelled out, "Wakey, wakey, eggs and bakey."
Totally. We'd wake up so fast.
So this time you can help me with the ingredients. I need you to grab me the actual eggs and the bacon.
I can handle eggs and bacon. Wowza. Chloe still eats the same cereal. So do I. I love that they still have the same refrigerator. I should evolve and become a vegan, but, bacon.
Come on, Max. Find those ingredients so we can chow down.
I keep expecting to see the sky turn red. Kate's life was sure worth a nice exploitive headline. Who drinks beer this early around here? Looks like a message.
David, this is Officer Korn. Just want to let you know your stepdaughter's car was identified near the Blackwell campus last night. Around the time of the break-ins.
What?
Give me a call soon.
Are you in trouble again, Chloe? Don't you sleep?
Message deleted.
Goodbye, message. I think Chloe has earned a break from all this bullshit.
Oh, jeez. Can you help me get this bird out of here?
Oh, look at the poor bird. He seems kind of freaked out. Bird, be gone! Fly, you fool! Three dead birds lined up? That's fucking ominous. Sitting in a swing always feels so comforting. I remember when Chloe and me would take turns in the swing. We would push each other so hard we'd fly way up in the air. Chloe always wanted to swing all the way around. I always got scared and would jump off before I flew off, trying to get high. I wonder how these birds died. Dead bird. Poor thing.
Come on, Max. Find those ingredients so we can chow down.
Joyce looks so different in her street clothes. The eggs always come first, as Joyce used to say.
Thanks. After all these years and everything that's happened, it's great to see you and Chloe together again. She hasn't had a good friend since you or Rachel. Oh, those clothes remind me so much of her. Such a sweet girl. I'm just hoping she's living large in LA.
I'd love to think that too, Joyce. But
we are on the same page, Max. I keep hoping that Rachel will show up or even send a message to Chloe from Hollywood. Or wherever she is.
I hate to even think this, much less say it out loud, but I think Rachel is in serious trouble.
I know. I watch those awful true crime shows, and it makes me ill if I think about Rachel ending up on one. So I don't think too much.
I see why Chloe is so obsessed with finding her.
Max Caulfield, are you actually jealous of Rachel?
Maybe. Rachel was so much cooler than me.
You think? Then why has Chloe been telling me she wishes she could be more like you over the past 5 years?
Doubt it. Did she really? 5 years ago feels like 1,000 now.
And that makes me, what, a century old? You're only 18, Max. Oh, youth. If only I could go back.
It's not all that, Joyce.
Voila, a breakfast fit for us queens. And a king. Go sit at the table. Go on, grab a seat, Max. I'm almost done whipping up this amazing breakfast.
I'm glad that's creamy and not crunchy. Thank you so much, Joyce. I'm never leaving this table.
Good, you can clean.
Bring those eggs and bacon to my belly. I guess nobody waters the plant here. I guess nobody waters the plant here. Kate's life was sure worth a nice exploitive headline.
Seeing you again, made me remember so much. I know these photos don't measure up to your work, Max.
My favorite photographers probably take pictures similar to yours. You make David happy, Joyce.
He wants us all to be happy, Max. He's just not great at showing it.
I don't think I can rock this outfit like Rachel.
You have your own cool style.
Wowzer. I totally remember that day.
I'm glad. William took this picture with his instant camera. Oh, it was the last picture he ever took. He had his car out right after this, and...
I know, Joyce. I'm sorry.
I didn't show you this to be morbid. In fact, I want you to have this. This was when my baby was so full of life and light. She was hopeful, positive. Everything she's not today. This was the last time I ever saw Chloe truly happy.
Did you guys have a bonding session about how fucked up I am?
It's not always about you.
Chloe, please. It's too early to start picking a fight. Eat instead.
I'll keep the warden busy while you go peek in the garage.
Now stop whispering or I'll know you're talking about me.
Stop being so nosy, Mother. Geez, I can't do anything around here without everybody getting up in my shit.
No one can even joke with you, Chloe. You fly off the handle like that.
Excuse me. I have to use the bathroom.
Sure, run off and pee when you should back me up.
Now who's being paranoid? Just listen to yourself.
Nobody else does.
I do need to get into David's computer. He's gotta be hiding shit. I bet David has all of his surveillance secrets in his laptop. No shit, it needs a password. How about step douche? Try again. I need more clues. Nothing to see here. Nothing in it. Naturally, David would buy a heavy-duty military padlock. I can even see the combination. That might be a useful password. There's no way Chloe can put that gun back now. Maybe this ID number might work. I could try the license number for the password. Looks like David has read this a lot. What did he learn? Maybe I could try stepdad for the password. David has been dragging his head around since 2001. Joyce might as well have wrote, "Let's get married." Joyce, that might be a useful password. Now the car looks ready to roll. This is a better hobby for David than surveillance.
Even David Madsen might be an angel to somebody else. That's cute. Could be a password here. Cute. Can't picture David driving Joyce around with this on the car. Obviously, David's parents care about him. That date might be a good password. Nope. Magic 8-Ball says no. No way, Max. You totally froze the laptop. Oh, shit balls. Such wrong. No way, Max. You totally froze the laptop. Worst hacker ever. Try again. No way, Max. Stop. Nope. Magic 8-Ball says no. No way, Max. You stop. Score! Max the Hacker strikes again. Whoa, spoiler alert. Rachel definitely hooked up with Frank. Why does David care? Instead of stalking Kate, David could have helped her. This is so wrong. Creepy bastard. I better tell Chloe about this now. It's just one more thing to make her sad and mad.
Nice breakfast.
David, you back already?
I have to take a nap after writing up vandalism reports last night.
What happened?
Some little shit-ass punks broke into the swimming pool. This is what happens at these PC bullshit colleges. Entitled students taking over the campus.
Do you know for sure it was Blackwell students?
Who else would do it? And I'm gonna bust them. Ugh.
figures you'd be here. Is that your Rachel Amber Halloween costume?
You know more about her than me.
No. You and Chloe think you know more than anybody. Like all teenagers.
Leave Max alone, David. Stop threatening students.
He threatens them with surveillance cameras, so he can spy on everybody. Like he spies on all of us here.
Don't start, Chloe. Not now.
Yeah, I'm just always starting shit, right? You're a total paranoid, David.
Not now, Chloe.
You used to call me a loser for getting kicked out of Blackwell. So who's the loser now, David? Who haven't you accused or harassed? Between your investigations into Rachel and Kate, what have you done besides get in trouble?
Listen! We don't know that David did anything, and nobody has any proof against him. As far as we know, it's Nathan Prescott who's the real threat so far. I would cut David slack here.
Oh, would you? How generous, King Max. So suddenly it doesn't matter how shady David has been acting, or that he keeps all those weird files on your classmates, or how you're always going off on how creepy David
is. I don't want anybody being accused of anything. There's been too much of that crap going on around here lately, and I don't want it in my home today.
Well, I agree with that. Now, if you all don't mind, I'd like to forget about work and sit down and eat some of this incredible grub.
I have to take a dump. Are you coming, Max?
Maybe I went too easy on David for Joyce's sake.
Thanks again for defending me, Max. But this is my family now.
Max, I appreciate you sticking up for David and our family. Even if Chloe doesn't.
Thanks for letting me down again, Max. Why can't you just rewind so I don't have to see you defending that asshole?
Listen, when I went through David's laptop, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank. Being more than friends.
Right, no way, Max. She was just posing to tease Frank.
If you're not gonna believe me, why don't we check out what Frank has in his RV?
What's that gonna prove?
Frank has Rachel's bracelet. What else does he have in there?
Motherfucker better not have anything, for his sake. Let's check the door. Frank gets so wasted, he sometimes forgets to lock it.
I can't believe you hung out with him.
Not anymore. We have to be casual ninjas here. Shitballs! Okay, here's the plan. I'll go to the diner and distract Frank by telling him I have his money, but he needs to come with me. Then you come in and rewind so Frank doesn't see me. Then you can tell Frank he needs to check out his RV, and then you rewind after you get the key, and...
Chloe, I got this. I'll be right back.
Don't let my epic plan get in the way of yours. I'll try to scrounge up a Scooby snack to distract his mangy mutt.
Now to find a quick and easy way to snag Frank's keys. What is going on here? I'd love to do a whole Big Rig photo series.
Good morning. How are the fish today?
Don't ask. First the snow, then an eclipse. What's next, a tornado?
I hope not.
Could be worse. We could get one of those California quakes.
True. Well, I'm feeling a little dizzy now. Hope you catch the big one today.
I better. Too late to switch careers now. See you around, kid.
That would be cool to be a trucker for a while. Always on the road.
Hey, how's it going?
Peachy. Interview over.
Having a bad day at the office?
Some punks messed with the train tracks, and now I have to wait for 3 days until I get my cargo. Time is money for a guy like me.
Oh yeah, that sucks.
Wish I could drive right out of goddamn Arcadia Bay. The whole town is crumbling. Snow, eclipse, that slut suicide.
Listen, Kate Marsh was not a slut. She was severely depressed for good reasons. You didn't even know her, did you?
I know all these Blackwell spoiled shit. Like that other loser I'd see around here, Rachel.
You knew Rachel Amber? Can you tell me about her?
Nope. Christ, why don't you get a real job instead of homework? I'd love to see you Blackwell turds try to drive my 1977 Needham 18-wheeler out there. Like I said, interview over.
Hey, no photo girl?
Do they teach English over at that arty farty school? I'm done talking. Over and out.
Hey.
Peachy.
Actually, I wanted to ask if that's your bitch in 1977 Needham 18-wheeler out there.
How the hell did you know that?
My friend Rachel Amber told me about this cool rig in town because I love taking pictures of truckers.
You knew Rachel? She sure didn't give a rat's ass about truckers or real work.
Oh, so you must have known her too?
Only from the diner. She was just a gold digger. She belonged in California with all those you-know-who-know-whats. Good riddance. But you can take pictures of my truck anytime. Take care.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Let's talk about my photo shoot later. 10-4.
I hate seeing old women on the street like that. Nice world.
Hi, how are you?
I remember you.
Max, can I get you something from the diner?
I heard about that girl killing herself at Blackwell. Awful thing.
Kate Marsh. I was with her when she jumped. I tried to save her. I swear I did.
Oh, honey. That was her choice, not yours. Don't you carry that weight.
I know. I'm starting to see that I can't change everything.
Especially when it comes to other people. Kate Marsh probably felt like she had nothing no more. I know the feeling.
But I need to find out who else is involved in this.
I'm probably a bigger snoop than you. People pretend to not see me, so I see everybody and everything.
Frank Bowers knew Rachel. Have you seen him around?
I saw him today, looking more jumpy than usual.
I don't know how he hasn't been arrested yet.
Sounds like you know a lot more than me, child.
I just think Arcadia Bay is in trouble.
Maybe you'd like to tell me what you're hiding.
I feel like I can trust you as much as Chloe. And you wouldn't think I'm crazy.
Too late for me to judge anybody. Plus, you're not crazy.
I'm just gonna say this. I had a vision of Arcadia Bay being destroyed by a tornado. For real.
Could be. Bad mojo is in the air this week. Thanks for the warning, Max. Thanks for that storm warning, Max. And, I'll let you know if I find out anything.
I hate seeing old women on the street like that. Nice world. Look at that. So sad and disturbing and beautiful at once. What an amazing shot. So ominous. Yes, another great day in Arcadia Bay. Good lord, bacon. I'm ready to nosh again. Ugh, but I need to get those keys from Frank. I wanted to see what would happen if I did this.
I'm gonna kill you.
Maybe we all did. Shit. What are the other signs then? Never mind me, officer. I'm just here to steal a drug dealer's keys. Nathan has time to get drugs from Frank because he was expelled. Can't drop any tunes right now. Keys. Looks tasty, but my need for keys comes first.
You show up after almost shooting me? You have serious balls, little girl. But hanging out with Chloe, playing with guns, and dressing like Rachel doesn't make you cool or tough. The fuck do you want?
How do you know these are Rachel's clothes?
Because she looks beautiful in them and you look like ass. Aiming a gun doesn't make you any sexier.
Grab your keys and let's check out your RV.
Let's not. You fucking creep me out.
In other words, Max, no keys. Maybe I eat like a pig. Try the floor.
I was eating those beans. Are you fucking insane? I was eating those beans! Ugh.
How you doing, Maxine? I'm so sorry you had to be up there with Kate when she, you know... Just know that we're proud of you for going up there.
Thanks, Officer Barry. I know you guys deal with this stuff way more than me, but it is hard to deal with.
I'm glad you're representing Blackwell Academy.
I guess Kate Marsh will be the face of Blackwell for a while.
Such a waste. Awful.
I feel like David Madsen represents Blackwell.
Not for long. He's a loose cannon. We all respect him for his service, but he's too eager.
He's eager to be a dick to me and Chloe.
That's true. He was ranting about a stolen gun, then I tuned out. Somebody's always out to get him. What can I do for you, Max?
I thought Nathan Prescott represents Blackwell.
Well, don't make me backwash this bacon. You know what the Prescotts represent.
Taking over Arcadia Bay?
You're not far wrong, Max. I heard the Prescotts are working on some new big land deals. Mr. Prescott helped out my family once a while ago, so I made a deal with him that I can't seem to get out of. Man, if I could get one instant replay in life. I better finish my breakfast first. What can I do for...
Well, I heard a rumor you were working for the Prescott family on the side.
Jesus, doesn't this town ever shut up?
I don't blame you for getting extra work.
Look, sometimes I check up on the Prescott family to make sure they're doing all right. Nathan included. Keep this quiet, Max.
Try interrogating somebody else, Lieutenant Caulfield.
Rachel! Whatever the fuck. Oh, look. Max Amber. Nice outfit. By the way, thanks for getting me fucking expelled, you twee bitch. You're lucky this is a public place.
Considering we're in a public diner with a police officer right over there, you shouldn't advertise your rage, Prescott.
Oh, yeah? You shouldn't have bitch snitched on me to that fucked up principal.
I bet you hoped that Kate Marsh would stay quiet.
Idiot says what?
Did you drug her?
You are so stupid, Max. You think you're so goddamn smart, too. Don't push me, girl. You don't want me for an enemy, understand? Do you?
Calm down, dude. We're in the diner.
Right. Plus, you're an adult now. I can sue your dumbass for libel. Thanks. Now fuck off, Dyke. Holy shit, what do you want now?
Your sugar daddy will always protect you and threaten me.
You don't know shit about my father or me. Nobody here does.
Then tell me what I should know.
Why? So you can pretend to care, hmm? Spoiler alert, he's an asshole.
Maybe I could help you.
I don't need you for anything except to stay out of my fucking business, understand? Now get out of my face. Holy sh...
Listen, Nathan. I'll take back everything I said about you. If you hook me up with Frank. Know what I mean?
You look like you've never even taken a hit of baby aspirin.
How do you think I stay wired all night studying? So is it a deal or not?
Calm down, hard up. Deal. You'll get your school supplies. Just go over to Frank and whisper, higher education. You'll hook your ass up. Holy...
I heard your dad hired a local cop to keep an eye out on you and Frank Bowers. Like a babysitter.
Bullshit! My dad doesn't hire. He owns. And these pigs know better than to narc on me.
Do they? I hope that means Frank won't get busted.
Eventually he will. Guy's into some freaky shit. He told me once he took a weird blood oath for Rachel. Forget I told you that. Seriously. Now get off my crack, whore. Keep your pie holes shut.
What can I do for you? What can I do?
Do you think Arcadia Bay is a weird town?
I'd take a normal city with normal problems about now. Makes me sick thinking about it.
What the fuck now?
By the way, Frank, I was wondering if you had any, higher education.
Oh, yeah, sure. Do you want the after-school special to go with that? Jesus. Look, I don't sell anything but bottles to feed me and my dog. I work for a living. Not like you spoiled Blackwell punks with too much time on your hands. But nothing. Don't ever ask me for anything ever again. Ever. Now back off. Get a new outfit. And leave me alone.
Damn, I really pissed him off. I need to go back.
What?
Could I get you to drop Chloe's debt?
Aren't you supposed to be a smart student?
You'll find out if you do me this favor.
Thanks, Godmother, but I don't need your favors. And Chloe doesn't get any from me.
What can I do?
Are you fucking stupid? Get out of my space.
Damn, I really pissed him off. I need to go back.
Holy.
Weren't you supposed to keep your mouth shut about the blood oath Frank took for Rachel?
Blood oath? Who? What the fuck? I never told anybody about that freaky shit. Besides, everybody knows Frank is a liar and a loser. Even Rachel did.
Yet Rachel Amber hung out with him more than you.
So? Rachel wanted Frank's stash. She let him take pictures, then he carries around her photo like she posed for love. Dumbass. Holy.
What the?
You know I saw that photo Rachel gave you.
How do you know about that? Huh? Chloe, right?
She just told me that one of Rachel's favorite pictures was the one she did for you.
Really? Yeah, I mean, that's what I thought. She was just a natural beauty, you know? Wait, let me find it. Here, judge for yourself.
I'm afraid I'll have to take your keys now, asshole.
You did not just do that. Give me back my keys, bitch. Give me my keys now!
Key brought. Now back to Chloe.
Watch out!
Quit thinking, Max.
Whew. That was close, Alyssa.
Okay, Max. This is the third time you've saved me from harm's way. You must be my angel.
Don't thank me. I haven't done anything special.
I saw you try and save my friend Gate on that roof. The only one who did. While people took camera pics.
Kate was my friend, too. I would have done anything to save her.
Everybody saw that. I'm proud of you for being so brave. You're pretty cool, Max.
That's not how I feel today, but thanks.
We need to hang out more. Drink some wine. I have to go, but let's talk later, cool? Thanks again, Max. Talk to you later.
Deja vu. There's dust on the dust now.
My Scooby snack, Chloe.
I should have known. The amazing Spider-Max.
I couldn't have done it without Frank. Now let's get in and out.
You'll need this, Max. On your mark, get set, throw! Get the treat, treat boy! I think we just made that dog our bitch. Get it?
Now we can snoop in peace, but let's not waste time. The doggy is busy now, but he might come back.
Damn, I thought my room was a shithole.
You're not a creepy drug dealer.
Frank has issues, but he's not creepy. At least I didn't think so until I saw him with Rachel's bracelet. Oh, we could cruise everywhere in this bad boy! Can you see us heading down the coast to Big Sur and beyond?
Yes, we'd be tearing up the highway. And you dare me to drive it like you dared me to kiss you? Chloe, we're on a schedule. We need clues about Rachel.
I know. Just daydreaming.
Zip, you scope the nada, area while I nothing.
Hack his computer for info.
I doubt Frank is trying out for the Arcadia Bay Brewers. The archetypal filthy guy dishes. No prize here. Frank must have a reason to keep a police radar nearby. That would be so cool to take this baby on the road with Chloe.
Crappy Wi-Fi out here. Must take him days to download the porn.
Yuck. Can't quite picture Frank and Chloe drinking beer and hanging out. I think the doggy likes his bone more. Pompidou? For reals? That's a poodle's name. Good to know Frank has a knife lying around. Of course Frank gets the munchies. Nice rig. Glad Frank treats something here with respect. Frank must spend all his drug money on baggies. Recycle, dude. Chloe isn't scared. Whoa, she's loving this. Stop it. How can somebody live like this? Too bad I don't have my Frank Bowers decoder ring. Are these for Frank, or is he selling them? Or both? That's a pretty extreme lighter. Is Frank going to deal online now? That's almost cute to see Frank posing with his dog. I could pry this vent open with the right tool. This is almost as good as a set of keys. Curses! Nothing here! Oh shit, the knife is broken. No more secrets.
I cannot believe he would wear a collar and a furry mask.
You're dumb. Ooh, Frank's stash. Okay, this vent is loose. I need something to pry it open. That's almost cute to see Frank posing with his dog.
I cannot believe—
My blade will open any portal. Oh man, Rachel and Frank's dog. I don't know if I should be touched or disturbed. I'm glad Rachel got to drive this beast. She looks genuinely happy. Rachel really did hang out with Frank. I'm learning more about Rachel than I want to know. Trouble in paradise. Chloe isn't scared. She's loving this.
That makes me ill that Rachel posed like this for Frank. I wrote him love letters. I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
Because she knew how you would react.
And she wasn't much of a friend, huh? Just another person who shits all over me. Why does everybody in my life let me down? My dad gets killed, you bail on me for years, my mother gloms on a stepfucker, now Rachel betrays me.
Chloe, Rachel is missing. Nobody betrayed you.
Bullshit! You totally defended stepstalker! Fuck everybody.
Chloe! Chloe, you can't keep blaming me and everybody for everything wrong in your life. It's so not fair.
I gotta blame somebody, otherwise it's all my fault. Fuck that.
Grow up. And I'm not trying to be mean, but you're not the only one in Arcadia Bay with problems. Kate Marsh killed herself, you know?
Yes, Kate Marsh killed herself. She's dead. Such sad, okay? That doesn't make me feel better about my fucked up life, get it?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
You blame William? Really?
Yes, I do. Damn right. He chose to go out that door and leave me forever.
Chloe, your dad didn't choose to leave you.
I know that, Max. My mom actually blames herself. Just because she wanted a ride home from work. Sometimes, even I blame her.
No, you don't.
Yes, Max, I do. Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? And he never does?
No, of course not. But I was with you that day. It was just a terrible accident.
I wish that made me feel better. But ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
You don't want to hear this, but you're still here. Alive. With me. And that is no accident.
You're right. I don't want to hear this.
Chloe, I can't do this out on my own. I need you with me. And Rachel needs you.
Oh my god. What is happening now?
Someday Dad'll get one of them newfangled computers.
I hope the flash didn't scare you, Max. This is a keeper.
Not until I see it first. You know the rules, Dad. Max, tell him.
Whoa, hey. You look totally pale. Are you okay?
Yeah. I just... Yeah, I'm fine.
Okay, Chloe. Give me the thumbs up or thumbs down.
Well, I might just allow this one into the family album.
You're the boss.
What is this?
But not the cook.
William is here.
Daddy.
Yes,
and
we can't.
Chloe is just a kid.
And serve us slackers.
Am I that far back in time?
You mean pancakes?
In France, they call them crepes.
I'm 18 years old inside my 13-year-old self.
If you want to eat.
How?
We. I volunteer to break the eggs.
Do you remember how many eggs?
Mom said it depends.
That's true.
So, how many eggs?
Don't you dare question the chef.
Right, like you're the real cook here.
Chloe is just so damn happy and carefree.
I'll let her know that.
And this is the last time, unless I change it. I love William like he was in my own family. I won't let him die today. I won't.
Now I get to take a picture. Strike a pose.
Make me a star.
Just make me look young.
I know I've seen those pictures before.
Hello? Hey, honey. Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Whales.
Joyce loves William so much.
What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get...
Oh, yeah. I miss movie nights here. Cookies and popcorn. I have to stop William from taking his car today.
Ladies, I have to go rescue yonder queen at the safe.
My family never took fun, goofy photos like this.
Mart, she doth have many bags of delicious grub for a...
I forgot about this. Back to the lighthouse.
It's to feast upon.
You are ridiculous.
You'll be grateful for that someday. Shit, where are my keys?
That's a
what a mess we made.
You
mean I remember those cool drawings I did with Chloe. Chloe was so into manga. Nice hair. I know they never took that big vacation.
Aha! You can't hide from me forever.
Sorry, wrong number.
Max, come on, you know better than that. Hello? Hey, honey. Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max. We're all going to work at the Two Whales.
Score!
What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course I'll come pick you up. Now I'll have an excuse to get a mocha. Be there shortly. Love you.
Excuse me, ladies, I have to go rescue yonder queen at the Save Mart. She doth have many bags of delicious grub for us to feast.
Man, I remember Chloe reading this.
Ridiculous.
You'll be great.
But not after today.
Shit, where are my keys?
That's a dollar for the swear jar!
You mean your college
That's bond. A cool snow dough.
Shit, where are those keys?
Another dollar for the
Obvious,
swear
but
jar.
It will have to do.
You're bankrupting me! I knew this thing would come in handy. How did my keys get in here? And no Chloe and Max wine tasting session.
Dad!
Don't blow it, because tonight your mother promised to make us a world-famous salmon surprise with chocolate cake for dessert. Max, you'll be here too, right?
She's never leaving me.
That makes all of us. I knew this thing. Oh. Keys.
Another.
Just making a fabulous breakfast with Chloe and Max.
I need to hide the keys where William won't hear his dumb beeper.
What? Oh, I didn't know you had to get groceries. Of course, I'll come pick you up. I know I had those keys right here. I know it. Forgot all about you, little buddy. Release the keys! Of course. Last time I ordered from Spy Guy Electronics.
You can take the bus, right? The stop is right down the street.
This I can do. Good call, Max.
Oh yeah, the bus is great. It comes every 15 minutes and there'll be plenty of room for you and Joyce and groceries and it'll save the environment.
You sold me already. I'm off to yonder bus stop. Joyce will love this.
Max, you are being so fucking strange. You feel okay?
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
All my friends in LA told me that Oregon was
Max.
And cold every day.
But never, Maxine.
So that's why she was laughing so hard.
I know, sorry, Mad Max. You're not pissed at me, right? Right?
No, it's people in Oregon.
Do you want to go hit the girls' potty and smoke a peace pipe?
I think Max is high.
She's acting like so weird. You cool, Max?
Nobody listened when I said we shouldn't let her in the vortex.
Courtney, you don't want anybody in the club.
Like, whatever, bitch.
Warren, he hooked up with Stella? Oh no, this is totally fucked up. What else have I changed? Chloe.
Thank you.
Max Caulfield. Taking a break after taking Seattle by storm, huh? We thought we'd never see you again after you left for the big city.
No. I'd never do that to Chloe.
Speaking of, I know she's been dying to see you. Hold on. Chloe! You have a visitor!